You decided on a lineup for tomorrow yet?
Yeah, sure have. Let me share that with you all,
if you will.
Okay, be happy to. Okay, so we're going to lead off with Josh Smith, who plays shortstop for us. Our two hole, I'm going to throw the young kid right in there, Nick Webb. He's going to play first base and bat two hole. Antoine will bat third and play right field. Cleanup will be Zach Watson in center field. Five hole will be Daniel Cabrera in left field. We've got four left-handed hitters out of five, and we're facing two left-handed starters the first 2 days. So, you know, we're gonna throw them right into the fire and see how they handle it. But I think those are our five best hitters, so I'm going to go ahead and stack them and see if it can work. When we get to six, seven, eight, nine, I'm a little bit uncertain, but right now I'm probably thinking six hole would be Bryce Jordan behind the plate. Seven hole would probably be his brother as a designated hitter, Bo Jordan. Eight would probably be Slaughter playing third base, and nine would be Brandon Russo playing second base.
Slaughter third.
Slaughter's been really good at third base. Yeah, he worked real hard. He's a high school shortstop, and he's got good hands and adequate enough arm. I think he'll do fine at third base. But he also is our best defensive first baseman. So, like I was telling, who was I telling this to earlier? He asked me a question about Hal Hughes. I think it was Jacques. You know, late in the game, there's a good possibility I may flip Slaughter over to first base. We're fortunate to have a lead, and we're trying to hold a lead to put Slaughter at first and use in at third to give us our best defense that we can have out there. But as far as being the everyday third baseman, Slaughter's more than adequate.
Is Josh leading off basically best OBP guy? Get him?
Yeah, pretty much so. We like having a guy that can lead off and hit a ball out of the park. I think if you look back at our leadoff through the years, it's not only been a guy who gets on base, but can maybe even lead off the game with an extra base hit. And Josh has home run power, as he just demonstrated in Omaha against Oregon State. But he's also got a really good eye, and it's tough to strike out. And if the lineup turns over, I always like to have a really good hitter leading off, too, because if you get the lineup to turn over and the bottom of the lineup does anything, then it leads you right into one of your better hitters. So I think Josh can do a really good job at the leadoff spot. And he let off, I think, in high school most of the time. So he's just in that spot in the order.
Stores and LeBas, how are they?
Labas is how you pronounce it. I know all the French people want to call him LeBas, but it's Labas.
Okay.
AJ threw a bullpen today. Looked really good. I have a hope date, March 3rd, that he would actually pitch in a game. That's what we're hoping for. Be using him probably out of the pen that day. Hoping that he could go a couple innings, and if things go well, potentially he could start in the middle of the week the next week. Stores has not advanced as far as Labas has. He had the bone spur cut off his shoulder. And then he was working good. Everything was going well and his throwing. And then one day he kind of overthrew in long catch and strained his lat muscle, his latissimus dorsi muscle. Of course, everybody knows where that is. You have such big latissimus dorsi.
You got me.
So anyway, he strained his lat muscle, and because of that, we had to shut him down for a week. So started back throwing now, and he's been throwing pain-free, but he hasn't gotten on the mound yet. In fact, he hasn't even thrown long catch yet. So we're hoping the next few times he throws, he doesn't aggravate it again, and that he'll be able to get on the pitcher's mound. So I would say he's probably a good 2 or 3 weeks behind Labas. So if we think Labas is March 3rd, Stores is probably closer to the end of March before he'd be ready to pitch any games. Just wait and see. Your guess is as good as mine, Mike. I thought he'd be ready to go. But I just have to trust the kid, and when he tells me he's healthy, then we'll go from there.